everybody. This is Ralph Emery along with
Connie Smith.
And we're on the air for
Campophonique, Beach Nut Chewing Tobacco, and Music City News.
Just fill in the blanks, don't you? Hey, and we're happy to have you with us, my friends. Connie, you doing all right today?
Yes, and I didn't even look. I've already memorized the sponsors.
Did you memorize the opening song?
Yes, and you know how to start a show, don't you, with Ray Stevens doing Misty.
Look at me, I'm as helpless as kitten love tree. I'm walking on a cloud, I can't understand, love. I missed it holding your hand. I walked my way, and a thousand violins began to play. Or it might be the sound of your hello. That music I hear, love, I missed it the moment you need. You can say that you're leading me on, but it's just what I want you to do. Don't you notice how hopelessly I'm lost? That's why I'm following you. Head from the glove, I missed it, too much in love. You can say that you're leading me on, but it's just what I want you to do. Don't you notice how hopelessly I'm lost? That's why I'm following you. Oh, should I wander through this wonderland alone, never knowing my right foot from the left, my head from my glove, oh, I missed it, too much in love.
Love that rendition. Love that record. That's Ray Stevens with an old Errol Garner song that he has put a little bluegrass arrangement around it. And it came out the way we just played it, called Misty.
Stop hurting, start healing with Campophonique.
Campophonique instantly stops the sting and itch of mosquito and chigger bites. These insects inject fluid into your skin, causing that fierce itch. Campophonique gets to this cause, penetrates the bite, and stops itching instantly. Helps prevent infection from scratching, so insect bites can heal fast. Use the penetrating first aid medication.
Campophonique.
Have you written for your free copy of Music City News, the country music paper the stars read? If not, remember this address. Music City News, Farron Young Building, Box 975, Nashville, Tennessee. Send a card or letter with your name and address, and you'll receive your free copy of Music City News in your mailbox. If you'd like to save money now, enclose your check for $6, and you'll receive Music City News for a full year and still get your free copy. The address is Music City News, Box 975, Nashville, Tennessee. Connie, who's your favorite singer?
George Jones.
Uh-huh.
Loretta Lynn.
George Jones and Loretta Lynn.
And almost all the rest of them.
You know, you used to listen to the radio a lot, but you...
Yeah.
I believe you said a moment ago you don't listen much
I've
anymore.
I've got to start listening again. I not only don't know the songs that's out now, I don't even know the singers.
Why don't you... Why don't you listen anymore?
I'm busy.
Okay.
I listen to a lot of wah-wah.
I mean, it's so noisy at your house, you can't hear the radio.
Yeah, and if it's not noisy, they're asleep, and I don't want to wake them up.
All right, for those fans who've never heard this story, you have told this on the show before some time ago, but I think it's kind of interesting, particularly since George Jones is your favorite singer, how you were discovered by Bill Anderson.
Oh, nothing personal, Bill. No, I'd always been, I'd never heard of Bill Anderson that time. He was just beginning to get going at that time. And, but George Jones was my favorite singer.
What's our time frame here? What year are we in?
1963.
And we're at a park at Columbus?
Near Columbus, Ohio, called Frontier Ranch. And I'd never seen a Grand Ole Opry star. And I had heard that George Jones was going to be there at the park that Sunday. So my husband and myself took off and went up to see George Jones. And someone had given me the wrong schedule. George had been there the week before, and Bill Anderson was there.
And you had never heard of Bill?
I had never heard of Bill at that time.
I see. Have you ever told Bill this story?
I have now.
Oh, go ahead.
So they talked me into entering a talent contest, and the same people had been on the contest for several weeks, you know.
You mean to tell me that where they had this same show featuring the Grand Ole Opry star?
Every Sunday they had a talent contest.
Okay.
And so I happened to win the talent contest.
What could you win?
I won $5 silver.
Okay.
And I got to meet Bill Anderson and shake his hand.
I bet that didn't knock you down since you had never heard of him.
Yes, it did, because he was a Grand Ole Opry star, and that's all it took to knock me down. But he was so nice, and I was scared to death, and I just wanted to shake his hand, and he kept talking to me. And I just was really surprised that he'd take the time. And he did, and he signed a picture for me and listened to me sing on the show that night, which was part of the winning. I got to sing on the show that night, and so we became fans of his, and through that, he brought me to Nashville.
Well, you make it sound awfully simple.
It was.
I presume that somewhere along the line he calls you from Tennessee, and you lived in Ohio, right?
Yes.
And he must have said, Connie, would you like to come to Nashville?
Well, we became a fan of his, you know, because he was so nice to us, and I liked his singing and his songs and all. So we would follow him around when he'd come to anywhere around that country. And about 6 months later, I saw him, and then we'd saw him about 3 months after that. And he said, well, you like it so well. He recognized me and my husband and took us out to supper. He said, well, you like this music so well. Why don't you come to Nashville? Well, I never thought that was possible. I just thought everybody had a dream, you know, and it wasn't really something you expected to come true. But he said, well, come down and do there in the Stub Record Shop. And so he brought me down in March of 64, the 28th of March, I flew down.
Almost a year then went by before you got this break.
Yes.
A year from the time he first saw you sing.
It was in August that he saw me sing, and then it was the next, it's from August to March.
All right,
then in May, I came back down.
We'll pick up the story, because her story that year, in 64, she became the Cinderella singer of 64. Stay tuned, folks. It'll be like a soap opera. Connie, what are you going to sing right here?
I'm going to do I Got a Lot of Hurtin' Done Today.
This was a recent hit for you.
Yes, by Whitey Schaefer. He wrote it.
Today read the phone book and I memorized some lines. I walked the floor 100 miles to places in my mind. Then I cried some tears and tried to count them one by one. Oh, there's so many things you never get done. But I got some hurting done today. I got a lot of pain out of the way. I didn't get through missing you, but one thing I can say, I got a lot of hurting done today. Time to do some things I said I'd do, like burn your photograph that's signed, darling, I love you. I didn't find the time to smile, the minutes slipped away. I've got some hurting done today. I got a lot of pain out of the way. I didn't get through missing you, but one thing I can say, I got a lot of hurting done today. I got a lot of hurting done today.
Miss Connie Smith, our special guest star. I can't say special. Our special guest star of the week with I Got a Lot of Hurtin' Done Today. Connie, you've told us that Bill Anderson brought you to Nashville in 1964 in March.
Yes. I spent $80 to fly down here, when that was about all the money we had.
Well, he didn't bring you. You came on your own.
Yeah, no. Well, he invited me down, and I flew down. And we didn't have enough money for both of us to come, so I flew down and sang on the Ernest Tubb Record Shop. And
now, that's a show at WSM in Nashville that follows the Grand Ole Opry, and where a lot of professionals and amateurs sing.
Yes. I got to go to the Opry, too, which was almost more than I could take.
Well, you got to meet some stars, I presume.
Yes, I remember I got to watch Bill Phillips' little boy while he was out on stage, and I thought that was great.
You mean you came to the Opry and got to babysit?
Yeah, well, I like that.
That was a thrill?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Then Bill Anderson must have taken your tapes around at Chet Atkins.
No, I didn't have any tapes at that time. I sent one later from a local TV show I did at WSAZ, and I'd sent it by a friend of mine, Dean Porter, who had been trying to get me down here, too. And Owen Bradley turned it down.
You were turned down by Decca Records?
Yes. And he wasn't all that knocked out. Well, then in May, Bill had some demonstration records to record, and he sent for me, and my husband and self came down, and I recorded the tape that he went to Minneapolis to a show.
You're making this awfully confusing.
Hubert Long took a tape to Chet Atkins.
All right, but you finally cut a demonstration record.
Yes.
All right, folks, did that demonstration record sell? Well, we'll be back to our story in a little bit. Here's Sonny James.
There you were, standing there, smiling as you made your plans. You were going to leave me and go with him. You said you loved him so, and your love would always be. But that's the very same thing you once told me.
And you still have my little golden band on your hand. Does my little band of gold mean nothing to you? To me it means the world, but you torn my world apart. You're leaving me alone with my broken heart.
There you were, standing there, smiling as you made your plans. You were going to leave me and go with him. You said you loved him so, and your love would always be. But that's the very same thing you once told me.
And you still had my little golden band on your hand. Does my little band of gold mean nothing to you? To me it means the world, but you've torn my world apart. You're leaving me alone with my broken heart. So take my little golden band from your hand. My little band of gold means nothing to you. To me it meant the world, but you've torn my world apart. You're leaving me alone with my broken heart.
Sonny James, Soul Son, with Little Band of Gold. Let's listen to Loretta Lynn.
I like the old time, preach and pray and sing and shout. I like the old time, reading of God's Word.
Neighbor, I want to send you that record and 30 others of my favorite gospel songs. Red Foley's Peas in the Valley, Old Time Religion Sung by Joe Maphis, Marty Robbins' What God Has Done. The list goes on and on. There are 31 songs in this big two-record album that I want to send to you. All you do is send 598 to me, Ralph Emery, Box 61, 110 21st Avenue South in Nashville. That's only 598 for 31 of the most beloved sacred songs of all to Ralph Emery, Box 61. 110 21st Avenue South, Nashville, Tennessee, 37203.
Hallelujah, glory. I like the old time worship of the Lord.
In our continuing story of Connie Smith, they finally took a tape to Chet Atkins.
Yes.
When?
In June of 64.
And he liked it?
Yes.
That same tape Owen Bradley had heard?
No, this was one that Bill made in Nashville.
This was another tape.
Yes. And so they, because of Bill being able to write my songs, which helped get the contract, Chet signed me on RCA, and I recorded once a day in July the 16th. And you remember on your show, your TV show in the morning, you presented me with that once a day when it was out in August. And it was number one at convention time, November.
So your first record went number one.
For 2 months.
And as I recall, you were named the most promising new female singer of the year.
Yes.
All in 1964. All right.
And then I turned into a pumpkin.
And 2 years later, this little gal came along, 1966, recorded Apartment Number 9.
Yes.
And then suddenly started making a lot of noise. Miss Tammy Wynette.
There goes that old steel guitar. And we're here in that same old bar again. And there goes that old saxophone. I know we won't be going home till Lord knows when. 'Cause when he hears that rhythm, he's gotta be out there with them. But if I stick by him long enough, I know I'll win. Now here comes that old fiddle, and he's right there in the middle of that same old crowd. That piano sure is ringing, and that singer up there singing sure is singing loud. Without me there to take him home, I guess he'd be there all night long. Sometimes I'm not proud of him, but I love him. 'Cause women in these places sure know how to fix their faces. But something tells me I won't have to look for lipstick traces. It taught me to live this life, but after all I'm still his wife. Sometimes I'm not proud of him, but I love him. There goes that old steel guitar.
That's Tammy Wynette, good record called There Goes That Old Steel Guitar.
We work in the sky where the steel grows high, me and my river Toulouse. Look out for each other like brother for brother, and beach nuts and tobacco we chew. There's no time to daydream, crawling on a steel beam, imagine what that teaches you. There's no maybe or might, friend, it had better be right. So beechnut's the tobacco you chew. When it comes to a man's chewing tobacco, it's got to be right. Beechnut's got that real tobacco taste you want. Rich, smooth, satisfying. Taste that stays that way all chew through. Try beechnut chewing tobacco. Once you do, you've got a friend for life. Your buddy's no stranger when you're sharing the danger, and he's more than a friend to you. The chances we take don't allow for mistakes, and beechnut's the tobacco we chew.
Connie, I know I've made this sound a little bit like This Is Your Life, but I did want to review 1964 because you hit so fast. You were an overnight sensation, the singing sensation of country music that year. And the first record, number one, Mercy. I think I'll go on now to another record.
Let's talk about Loretta.
No, not, Loretta's not coming up right here. This is David Wills.
Take a minute and think of what you're doing. You're giving your love to any man. When they tell you they love you, you believe them. But it never works out like you planned. From ballroom to bedroom, that's where your love goes. And I know you're unhappy, 'cause woman shows. They won't let you be a lady, 'cause everyone knows. From barrooms to bedrooms, that's where your love goes. You've been looking in all the wrong places, for true love you can't seem to find. But if you just look over your shoulder, you'll see I've been here all the time. From ballrooms to bedrooms, that's where your love goes. And I know you're unhappy, 'cause woman shows. So let me love you, and I'll take you from this life that you've known. From ballrooms to bedrooms, I'm taking you home.
That's David Wills. David, who is a Tennessee boy, I believe from Pulaski, Tennessee, singing From Barrooms to Bedrooms.
Friends, this is Connie Smith right here, and I'm enjoying being with Ralph and enjoying getting to sing another song for you. This is called Ain't Love a Good Thing.
Blues, go ahead and knock upon my door. You can't hurt me anymore. Ain't love a good thing. Rain, go ahead and let it rain all night. In the morning I'll be dry. Ain't love a good thing. Well, ain't it good to know that love can take away the rain and make the sun shine again? And ain't it good to know that love can take a lonely dream and turn it into a real thing? Ain't love a good thing.
another heart to ache, and another mind to break. Mm-hmm. Ain't love a good thing? Time, find yourself another fool to waste, and another place to stay. Well, ain't it good to know that love can take away the rain and make the sun shine again? And ain't it good to know that love can take a lonely dream and turn it into a real thing? Mm-hmm. Ain't love a good thing?
Our guest star of the week, Miss Connie Smith, with Ain't Love a Good Thing. Let me ask you a question, Connie, about immediate success, at least after you got to Nashville and got on a major record label. Well, first of all, how long had you been in show business?
Professionally, not really. I was doing a TV show for like 8 or 9 months before that on WSAZ TV in Huntington. But
Huntington, West Virginia?
Yes, and it was so professional that when I forgot my words, I ran to the ladies' room right off camera. That's how professional I was.
Yeah,
I really did. I just get scared to death, and I'd realize I'd forgot my words, and I'd just take off. There wouldn't be nobody on camera.
What, I was going to ask what they do for a body on camera.
Dean had to take it. Dean Sturm.
Was he on the singer on the show?
He was the MC.
Boy, that's,
he reminded
that's
me
awful,
of you, Ralph.
Why?
He was terrible.
Huh?
He was terrible.
You shouldn't get on me. Now, you're the one that preached to me about hurting people's feelings.
Well, Ralph, you know I love you.
What if, I'm not talking about me. I'm talking about him. What if he's listening?
Oh, well, he knows I love him, too.
Oh, okay. As long as he knows. what I was going to ask you, with that instant success on RCA, first record number one, does that spoil you? Is that hard to accept, hard to cope with?
No, for me, Ralph, it was hard to believe. I didn't realize it. I guess the biggest thrill for me was just to get to hear a record of mine on the radio, and that's the most thing it meant. I didn't
Where
really
were
know
you
what
you
it
first
hit.
Heard your record on the radio?
I was coming up a mountain in West Virginia, and I leaned out the window to get the aerial up and about fell out of the car because it was fading out. But that was what it meant so much to me. I had no foundation. I didn't know what it meant. Maybe it would have spoiled me if I'd have known what it meant, but I didn't.
But you came into this from rather poor circumstances, didn't you?
Yes, and I was scared to death. And it was really rough by having no foundation.
Didn't you suddenly start making some money?
Oh, $50 or so.
No, I
made $50 a day when Once a Day was number one. It happened so fast.
Well, how soon did they get the price up a little bit?
Well, they got it up to 75 before it went down. I've never really had any business management as far as we just didn't know what we was getting into. So it Once a Day didn't sell. People think it was a million seller, and it wasn't anywhere near. It wasn't even a half a million seller. But it just happened so fast that it wasn't taken care of.
How many did it sell?
Oh, I don't know. I remember at one time it had sold about 300,000.
Well, that's a good size hit, though. 300,000 records.
10 years ago, yeah.
Wouldn't you like to have that just about any time out?
Yeah, I need one of those now.
Was $50 a day a lot of money to you then?
Yeah, except for the fact that we were traveling on the road and, you know, going so much that we had to come home and take money out of our savings to pay our expenses.
You mean you weren't making a profit?
No.
How long could that go on without you going broke?
Well, I've been broke most of the time.
You mean you operated at a loss with a number one record?
Yeah, I did.
That's incredible. All right, let's bring on old John, or Big John. Johnny Russell singing Hello, I Love You.
I said, Hello, I love you. She said, Hello, how are you? I said, Have you forgotten me? She pretended not to hear.
I was downtown yesterday, feeling low and taking care of a little business. When I saw her through the window of the California ladies' fashion shop, she always did know how to dress. She always kept herself looking young and pretty. Since our divorce, we hadn't talked. I pushed my pride aside and walked on in. Her auburn hair was hanging long. I can't recall her ever looking better. She was trying on the latest style, and her form filled the fashion oh so well. I thought I'd ask how things had been and see if I could do anything to help her. But she seemed to be much more concerned with finding shoes to go with her new dress. I said, "Hello, I love you." She said, "Hello, how are you?" I said, "Have you forgotten me?" She pretended not to hear. I said, "Hello, I need you." She said, "How are things with you?" I got the message. She came through. I said, "Hello, I love you."
That's Johnny Russell on this show. John with a hello song. Conway Twitty came on this show one time and he said, "I think there is a formula for making hit records." At the time, he had Hello Darling. He said, most hello songs hit.
Hello Walls.
Hello Walls. Hello Out There by Carl Ballou.
Hello Love.
Hello Love, right. I had one called Hello Fool. Remember that?
No.
You may laugh. You may laugh, but it was a hit.
I remember I cried at ball games.
No, no, don't bring that up, please. That was awful. But anyway, if Conway's formula for success applies, then Johnny Russell's got a hit. Johnny Russell with Hello, I Love You. Connie, do you read the Music City News?
Every month, Ralph. I think Music City News is great because I catch up on everything that's happening in country music because I hadn't been on the road in a while.
And fans, if you'll send a card or letter with your name and address to Ralph Emery, Music City News, Farron Young Building, Box 975, Nashville, Tennessee, I'll send you a free copy. Or you can start a year subscription at a savings by sending $6 and still receive your free copy.
I think all you country music fans had better grab a pencil and jot down the address because Music City News is better than almost anything I can think of.
Stop hurting, start healing with Camphophonique.
Camphophonique instantly stops pain of minor cuts, scrapes, cold sores, burns. Penetrates skin injuries to kill germs. Penetrates insect bites to stop the sting and itch instantly, even the mosquito and chigger bites. Helps prevent infection, so insect bites and skin injuries can heal fast. Use Camphophonique, the penetrating first aid medication.
Camphophonique.
Connie, time has a way of flying rapidly by.
Yes, it does.
A couple of years ago, you were on this show with me, and we were introducing a new singer. Do you remember that show?
Yeah, I sure do.
Miss Tanya Tucker, and she had Delta Dawn out, and she was rapping with us on the show, and somehow we got her into singing a little bit of an old country song on the show, and she went on to tell a little bit about how she was discovered. So for an Emery memory this week, let's go back and listen to Tanya. Now, Tanya said, "You don't want to hear me sing it. Let me hear you sing it."
Go you
ahead.
You hear me?
Go ahead. So go ahead and sing Don't Be Angry.
Okay. Don't be angry with me, darling, if I fail to understand.
Whose version are you doing?
Well, that's Billy Crash's version.
You got a little vibrato in your voice, haven't you?
That's what Billy Sherrill tells me, yes.
Do you believe everything Billy Sherrill tells you?
Yeah, I do. I better believe it.
I once heard, and you can correct this story if I'm wrong,
all right,
that Billy Sherrill saw you on a television show and signed you based on your performance on the show. I believe the show was The Tonight Show.
No.
That story is wrong.
False, right.
Okay, give me the true story.
A friend in Las Vegas introduced the tapes to Billy, and he heard them, and he wanted to meet me, and so we met, and he signed me up. He liked the tapes. He didn't see me. He saw me after he'd heard the tapes.
Did he realize you were just a kid, 13
yes,
years old at the time?
He sure did.
But you don't sound like a kid.
Well, maybe that's why he signed me up. I don't know.
Have you been through the voice change?
I think I have, yes. When I was 9 years old, I had more of a twang in my voice, you know. I had I was singing through my nose, you know.
Carrying the same theme a step further, Tanya Tucker has now left Billy Sherrill. And after being offered a lot of money by another record company, she went on to MCA Records. You remember when she was on the show, how she wanted to sing all the songs?
Yeah, and she told us at that time she was going to be a superstar.
Well, I think she was a prophetess anyway.
Yes.
Here's Tanya's latest record.
You came riding in on the sunrise on a hot West Texas day. A fancy man in a painted wagon with some fancy things to say. Looks like you folks need some water. Well, water is my game. And for the small price of $100, I bet you I can make it rain. So step back, non-believers, or the rain will never come. Someone start that fire burning, somebody beat the drum. He said, some may think I'm crazy for making all these claims. But I swear before this day is over, you folks are gonna see some rain. They all just stood there staring, trying to believe. But there was one named Lizzie Cooper who said he was a lying cheat. She said, you call yourself a rain man, well, you ought to be ashamed. Starting all these people dreaming, thinking you can make it rain. So step back, non-believers, or the rain will never come. Someone keep that fire burning, somebody beat the drum. He said, some may think I'm crazy for making all these claims. But I swear before this day is over, you folks are gonna see some rain. Hey, Lizzie, well, a man's got to have a dream. And if you can't walk on the inside with me, I'll meet you in between. Oh, come with me, Lizzie, and the stars will write your name. And if you still think I'm lying to you, look yonder, there comes the rain. Step back, non-believers, or the rain will never come. Someone keep that fire burning, somebody beat the drum. He said, some may think I'm crazy for making all these claims. But I swear before this day is over, you folks are gonna see some rain.
That's Tanya Tucker with Lizzie and the Rain Man. Miss Connie, I will turn to you for an introduction.
Oh, is that one of my boys? Waylon Jennings, he's going to sing one called Dreaming My Dreams With You.
I hope that I won't be that wrong anymore. Maybe I've learned this time I hope that I find what I'm reaching for, the way that it is in my mind. Someday I'll get over you. I'll live to see it all through, but I'll always miss dreaming my dreams with you. But I won't let it change me, not if I can. I'd rather believe in love and give it away as much as I can to those that I'm fondest of. Someday I'll get over you. I'll live to see it all through, but I'll always miss dreaming my dreams with you.
All righty, Waylon. You did it again, you son of a gun. Waylon Jennings with Dreaming My Dreams with You. Right now, I want to play just a bit of a very special record for you.
Oh, well, I'm tired and so weary, but I must go along.
Isn't that beautiful? Red Foley and Peace in the Valley. You can have that song and 30 other inspirational gospel songs, including Ray Price singing The Old Rugged Cross, Johnny Cash, I Saw a Man, Loretta Lynn, Old Camp Meeting Time, and 27 additional beautiful songs in this record offer. All you need to do, neighbor, is send $5.98 to me, Ralph Emery, Box 61, 110 21st Avenue South, Nashville, Tennessee. For this big two-record, 31-song album, send $5.98 to Ralph Emery, Box 61, 110 21st Avenue South, Nashville, Tennessee, 37203.
Friends, this is Connie Smith, and right now I'd like to sing I Never Knew. La da da da, la da da da. I've sang goodbye a thousand times in a song to make words rhyme, until the day when you walked out the door. Honey, I never knew what that song meant before. That pretty song about someone gone, those catchy lines are touching home. I don't think that I could get through it anymore. Honey, I never knew what that song meant before. And now the words go to my heart, then I feel my teardrops start. When I sing those words, you don't love me anymore. Honey, I never knew what that song meant before. That pretty song about someone gone, those catchy lines are touching home. I don't think
la da da da, la da da da.
Our guest star of the week, la da da da, Connie Smith with "I Never Knew." We have to hurry. Connie Smith, thank you very much.
La da 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 to you too, Ralph.
See you tomorrow?
Yes.
Our show presented by Campo Phonique, by Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, and by the Music City News, and we thank you for listening.